Hello guys, this is Virendra Singh and welcome back at MasterCam MIL 3D Tutorials and Toolpaths. This is our MasterCam MIL 3D Part 2 tutorial. This is our second tutorial and second tutorial, that one is Part 2. And in this video, we discuss about that how we can manufacturing that one component by the help of MasterCam MIL 3D operations. So in this video, you will learn different type of operations. So let me show you that how it will be looks after the machining all operations. So that one is our part after the completing of all machining, that part is looking like that one. So in this video, we discuss about different type of operations in MasterCam MIL 3D. The number one operation for the roughing purpose which we are going to discuss about, that is known as roughing operation for the area rough. That one is operation is known as area rough. After that area roughing operation, again we will also discuss about that one of the most important thing in a MasterCam MIL 3D, that is stock model, that how we can create stock model for that any kind of parts. And after that we will discuss about that two different type of finishing operations. The number one finishing operation is raster and the second one finishing operation is pencil. So let me start that one part, that how we can create that kind of a very simple and easy part. So for creating that one part, in our last video I discussed about that how I can made model for that one component. If you want to learn that how we can model for that one component by the help of different type of surface steps, you can watch our last one video. The link is still available in the I button and the description, and you can also check it out from our MasterCam MIL 3D playlist. So for creating that kind of part, first I have to arrange that one part as per, and I have to make proper plane selection and I have to make proper WCS selection. So for creating a proper way in a WCS selection, so let me show you that how that will be process I have to done. So for creating a proper WPS or a plane, I have to go in a wireframe, create a bounding box. After selecting on a bounding box, select all and selection. So when I was selecting a bounding box, so that time it will be make a box like that kind of. So that box is showing that the how and what is the raw material size. So for example, what is the X size, what is the Y size, and here what is the Z size. So I just increase Z size also in a few numbers. So our Z length is 70 mm, Y length is 150 mm, and X length is 210 mm. In this video I just follow the only MasterCam MIL 3D process. I don't follow the facing or outer operation, that you can easily done and you can easily learn in a MasterCam MIL 2D tutorials. Now I have to click OK. When I click OK, so that time there is a one bounding box created as you can see. So now what I have to do next one process, that I have to machining from, so that time that now my WCS is now here at, but I have to create from the top plane. So for creating my WCS at here, I have two options, that I have to create new WCS at here, and also then second one option is I have to move that one part from here to here. So for movement that one part from here to bottom side, I have to go in a transform, move to horizon, and I have to just click here. So when I just click at here, so that time as you can see here, my part is just moving from the top area to Z0. So now I just make a part at a proper place. Now the next one process that I have to do, that is I have to machining that one part. So for machining that one component, I first have to select machine. For selecting a machine for MasterCam MIL 3D, I have to go in a machine option and then mill and default. So for after selecting the machine, the first process that I have to do, that I have to select the raw material size. For selecting a raw material size, I have to go in a properties, tool selection, first default program number, ascent wall, duplicate, and all the process is same as we do in a MasterCam MIL 2D all things. But here the next one process that we have to follow, that is known as stock setup. So for creating a stock setup for that one component, we have to come in a stock setup page. When we are at the stock setup page, first what we have to do, we have to create a stock setup, and the first we have to select what is shape of for our stock. So as you know, our stock shape is rectangular. So I just click shape in a rectangular, and now the next one thing is I have to select entire stock. So for selecting all entire stock, I just have to click all entity. When I just click on all entity, so that time automatically MasterCam calculate all the value in X, Y and Z, all these three directions. Now I have to press OK. So as you can see, when I just clicking on the OK, so that time there is a one red new line is created. So that red new line is showing that what is our stock size and how it looks. So now the next one process that I have to follow, that I have to create when we are working on a MasterCam MIL3D. So that time MIL3D is always analyze our stock model. So for analyzing stock model, first we have to create a new stock model. So for creating a stock model, we have to go in here at the stock model. We have to just click at the stock model. When we are clicking on a stock model page, so first what is there is a one window is blinking, and that is first we have to input here name, that what is the operation name. So I just input the name is stock model. When we are inputting the name of the stock model, so that time we can here select what is the color of that part. So we can choose any kind of color of that one stock model. So I just selected any default color. So next one, what is the next one process is that we have to select what is the shape of stock model as we create in our stock size. So our shape is stock, shape of the stock is rectangular. We can also select any kind of model, cylindrical shape or if any file. So now our shape is rectangular. Now what is the rectangular, what is the size? So size is as same as a stock setup. So I just click on a stock setup. So automatically MasterCam calculated values from the stock setup page. So now the next one process is I have to just click OK. So when I just click OK on that one page, so that time here, as you can see here, that is so that is our stock size or stock part, and I have to machining that one part and I have to create that one component. So let me show you. So after creating our raw material size or stock model, the next one process that I have to follow, that I have to machining that one part by the help of MasterCam MIL3D operations. So first operation that I have to follow or I have to create, that is known as area roughing operation. For creating of area roughing operation, I just have to click at here area roughing. When I just click on the area roughing operation, so there that time there is a new window is blinking here. So that first thing is I have to visible, that is the machining, the area which I have to select. What is I have to machining? So for selecting that one area, I just have to click select entity and control A. So that time all area will be selected in a one step. So here that next one process is stock. So I can adjust or I can make stock as per my requirement. So in a wall as well as the floor. So make a stock in a wall, that is 0.2, and in also in a floor, that is also 0.2. So next one process, that is the tool path control. When I was making roughing operation, so that time tool path control is not required. So the next one process is that is tool. What is the tool I have to selecting for selecting that? So here this page is define us that how the tool we can selecting, and we what the process that I have to follow for the selecting a tool. So for selecting a tool, I just have to click on a select tool, select library tool, and then I have to click on a filter. So when I was clicking here, so I have first tool for a roughing purpose, I have to select that is 20 mm of diameter. So I just click that one first tool, that is 20 mm R2, means ki corner radius is 2 mm and the tool diameter is 20 mm. Now I just have to click OK. Here I have to input what is the feed rate, what is the spindle speed and what is the plunge feed rate. Here I can also input a comment for a reference purpose. So the next one process is that is holder. I can select a holder or a specific holder as per my requirement. And the next one process for a MasterCam MIL3D. In this one operation for area roughing, in this operation first step I have to done, that I have to create a stock model. So now in that one treehouse, in a stock page, I have to define the stock model as per my stock size. So I just click on a stop, and here I have to mark rest material. So what is the rest material? So I have to click on one other operation. When I was selecting all previous operation, so that time it is defined all previous operation, but I have to select only one operation, that is my stock model. So I also selecting my stock model as a operation. Then the next one step I have to follow, that adjustment to remaining stock. In a here at the adjustment to remaining stock, I have to click, I have to define any kind of distance. That distance is I have to input 0.3, that is calculated at what is the stock I have to define and what is the tolerance for that one part. Then that here the stock I have defined, that is 0.2, and tolerance value is 0.1. The next one is step is that cutting parameter. At here cutting parameter, I have to define that how our area roughing operation is remove material from the stock. So that first thing is the cutting style. The cutting style I have to select, that is clamp and conventional. So I have to just click on a clamp milling. Then optimize cut order, I am always on that one. The next one thing is step down. Step downs means what is the depth of cut I have to define here. The depth of cut is 0.4 or a 0.3 mm for the 20 mm of R2 nose, R2 ball nose tool. And the next one step that I have to follow, that keep tool down within. When I was doing Mastercam Mill 3D, so that time I have to always selecting that one operation. Percentage of tool diameter is 100% of tool diameter. So that is sometimes calculated for when tool is coming in the air and what will be the movement like that one. And the next one step, that is when we are doing area roughing operation. So that time two parameters are valuable. First thing is what is step down, and next one is what is XY step over. XY step over is what is the tool diameter using. So that the tool diameter I have just is using that 55% of tool diameter. So that time in a one pass, the 55% of tool diameter using as a per pass. And the next one thing is that corner radius. I have to mark also the corner radius. When I was mark corner radius, so that time in our part, very there will be at a few places that corners will be in a sharp. So that time when I was mark on a corner radius, so that time there will be no sharp corner in our tool path. The next one step is I have to go in a transitions. When I was on that one page, so I have to define here what is the entry method I have to select it. So for a selecting entry method, we have a two choice. That number one choice is entry by the helix method, and the second one choice is entry by the help of profile ramp. So I just click select entry by the help of profile ramp. So after selecting the entry by the profile ramp, I have to define few things. That one thing is our Z clearance. So Z clearance is 2 mm, as we know also, that is plunge. Profile ramp is also similar as the previous pocket operation, and there is a different type of operation. So Z clearance I have to always define 2 mm. Plunge angle I have to define 5 mm. And when we are doing any kind of inserted end mill, so make sure here when we are machining by the help of any kind of inserted end mill, so that time skip pocket smaller than, always we have to define 200%. And we are when we are doing without inserted end mill or a fluid end mill, so that time it should be 0. The next one step is steep and shallow, that I don't have required to define. And the next step, steep and shallow means what we can also control what is the depth. When I was input the depth, maximum depth 10 mm, so that time the tool will be only removing at the minus 10 mm. But I have to machining that one part as per the selecting of our surface, so I don't have required to define. So that next one, next and final parameter is linking parameter. So at here at the linking parameter, first that I have to define what is the retract here, that what is clearance plane. So I just have to define the 50 mm clearance plane from the Z0. And the next here step is what is the retract and how it will be retract. Though I have just defined the minimum retract value, make sure and be make always remember that when you are selecting minimum vertical retract, so that time that box should be always on a mark, or you can, you have to define what is the feed move. It means that what is should be feed when the part is clear, part is machining and any kind of single part, and after that the part is removing from one place to another place. So I have to define what is the feed movement, that is 5000, or that we can define according to the our machine. Then the next one thing is part clearance. Part clearance means at here, part clearance means when our part is machine part, when our tool is movement from one place to second place of the part, so that time what will be the retract value, or that is I have to define at the here. I have just defined that 5 mm, so that time when our tool is retracting from one place to other, so that time it will be retract 5 mm. And then the last one parameter that I have to define, that arc filter. At here I have to define what is the tolerance, so I have to define the tolerance value 0.1, and I just press OK. When I do all the things parameter and I have to make all the parameters, so that time here our operation is generating. When our operation is generating, so that time it is showing like that. So maybe possible within a few minutes our operation is generating. So as you can see here, our my operation is done and all things are, as you can, visible in a proper way. So if you want to simulate in a 3D, so let me show you in how that operation is simulation in a 3D part. So for simulation, that one component in a 3D, I just have to click on here. When I just click at here, so that time automatically 3D simulation is open and I just have to play. So as you can see here, my part is removing all the unwanted material and it make a shape like as per our requirement. So when it is machining, the diameter is 20 mm, so all corners, all small areas are not machining. So that time after machining of that one component, again I have to do rest roughing operation. Rest roughing operations means that first I have to doing the most removing mostly material, then the material which is already here or created, so I also have to remove that one. So for that one, removing that one material, I have to do rest roughing operation. So let me also show you that how we can do rest roughing operation. So after machining that one part, I have to do rest roughing operation. So for creating a rest roughing operation, the simple trick is I have to select both of these operation. I have to copy for a control C, or you can also click on a right click, copy, and here paste. So that time what is happening, our stock and operation both are copy. So I have to change few parameter. I have to just click on a stock model, click on a parameter. Now I have to define that stock model 20 R2, means 20 mm diameter of tool I am using and 2 mm of radius I am using. So that is the new name of our stock model. Now I have to also select the new stock, the new color. Then the next one thing is, what is the stock shape? That stock shape is, that is stock model. And the next one step, I have to define that source operation, that which operation I have to select. So when I was selecting that one, my area roughing operation, so that time there will be a new stock model will be generated, and that new stock model is generated as per the removing of the material by the help of that one surface high speed operation. So it will be take time to create it. When we are generating any kind of operation, and it will take more time, so we can go in a view and click at multi-thread, make a right click and real time. When we are pressing or we are following that one operation, so that time that processing time or a program creating time is automatically reduced, and I just press OK. So here, so as you can see, our new stock model is done. and that new stock model is as per what is the material removing. Material will be still available after machining of over that one part. So for creating our rest roughing operation, I just have to click here that one operation, and I have to just click on a parameter. So all things will be remaining same. I have to change my tool. For changing my tool, I have just go for the select tool library, filter, and I just click 6 mm of ball nose. So I just click on a 6 mm of ball nose, and that corner radius is 1 mm. So as per the tool, I can change what is spindle speed and all the parameter as per requirement. Then all parameters will be same. The next one parameter that change is required, that is stock. So when I was selecting that last one operation, so that time stock model is that, but for that one operation my stock model will be that one. So I just change my stock model. As you can see, that is I am doing area roughing, that is rest roughing operation. So which one material is resting, that is that one operation. And now that is we have to come in a cutting parameter. At cutting parameter, we have to define what is the step down, then transitions and translations. At translations, make sure the all parameters will be same, but that skip pocket is smaller than that parameter automatically changes. So I just have to again define 2000%, so it will be automatically calculated as per our parameters. And now I have to press OK and regenerate. Here our part is done, and as per our stock model or our last material, that MasterCam automatically calculate tool path as per what is the rest material is as at our part. So in this operation our all rest material will be removing. So let me show you in a 3D simulation. Now for creating 3D simulation, I have to define the stock model, that is that one stock. So for creating that one, that what is the process I have to follow? I have to go in simulations option, and I have here I have to define stock model, that what is the stock model size, stock model, that is stock model after 20 R2, and OK. And now I have to click 3D simulation. So when I was selecting that one 3D simulation, so that time stock model is that is here visible, that is over that one stock model 20 R2. And now I have to play. So MasterCam automatically removing the material which is still available after the roughing off. So MasterCam area rest roughing operation is automatically removing all the material as per the tool size. So now the next one process I have to do, that I have to machining for a finishing purpose. So for creating a finishing tool path, I am going to introduce you, or I have to define you, that next one operation is, that is raster operation. So before creating a raster operation, that one video, I will create a new raster operation in next one video. So I wish you have understand all the things that I have to define or I have make for a roughing operation. The number one operation is, that is stock model. Then the second one operation is for a roughing purpose, and again I have to create a stock model, and I reduce the tool diameter. So that time MasterCam also machining over a small area. So I wish you understand all the things. So thank you very much. Be connected and updated for more videos. I wish you understand all the things.